originally from Calexico. It's been a long time, but you know, I really miss Calexico. Right. Seriously, you know what I miss about Calexico? Mexicali. That's what I miss. I miss the tacos, but you know what I miss? What's so great about Mexicali is the Chinese food, right?
Yeah.
Chinese food, and you go to Mexicali, you're like, the Mexican food sucks. But the Chinese food, right? And the funny thing about the Chinese food over there is that the guys that are working there are Chinese, and they're talking in Spanish, but they still sound like they're talking in Chinese. This fucking speaking Spanish, how can I understand that shit? Right? And they got some guy in the back, you know, and it's always like the third cousin, right? He just barely turned legal. He's like 16 and he's working in the back. Don't fuck up. Don't fuck up, okay? You make an egg full young, it's not egg, it's not young, it's just full. This wasabi, this green tea ice cream, don't fuck it up. Beating that shit, right? And it was like, ugh! And then, like I said, then there's the tacos, right? You gotta love the tacos over there, right? Who loves the tacos? Come on! Yes, all right. You know, and oh shit. Let there be light. Butt light. Alright. Yeah, there we go. Alright, throw one up. Alright, so then I was talking about the tacos, right? You can have like a lengua, you can have the sesos, and then, you know, they might as well have culo de caballo. Horse's ass, for those of you that don't speak Spanish. Okay? You hear me, motherfucker? Okay. And then it's like, you know that there are some fuckers that are driving over there purposely to go find culo de caballo, right? They're like in that car. We gotta find the culo de caballo. You can smell it, right? And they get over there and they're like licking their fingers. You know, God damn, that shit is good, you know? And the taquero is like, hey, how's those tacos? And you're like this. You're like, how many more would you like? Never once did I get sick in Mexicali, right? But then you come back to Calexico and you eat a jack-in-a-box and you're like, ugh. Fucking jack-in-a-box. Or as they say in Calexico, yak-in-the-box. You go up to the drive-thru, right? And, you know, I try to speak as much English as possible. And I'm placing my order. Pinche Mexicano is like, yes, you know? And they're like, you drive up, and then there's always some vieja. It's like 12 midnight, and they give, like, the worst shift to the worst people, right? Some vieja's working there in the middle of the night, and she's like this.
Welcome to Yuck in the Box, man. Take your order.
You're like, yes, I'd like a jumbo jack with cheese, curly fries, and a large Pepsi. And then she reads it back to you, right? A jumbo jack with cheese, curly fries, and a large Pepsi. Jumbo Jack with cheese. See, jumbo yak con cheese. I don't want a fucking yak in my jumbo. And cheese is something you play, not something I want in my food. And a Pepsi. Okay, una Pepsi. Toma, ahí está. Okay? You know what? If you really want to fuck around with these people, you go through the drive-thru, do this next time. Like when you're at McDonald's or something like that, and they're like, you know, welcome to McDonald's. May I take your order? And you're like this.
Yes, I'd like a Big Mac with large fries and a large coffee.
And, you know, the girl was black. She's like, say what? And now you sound pissed off, right?
I want a Big Mac, large fries, and large coffee. I don't understand. Was there a problem?
She says, you know, pull over. You know, so I had to pull up to the window. And then she called her manager, right? And the manager's over, and she goes, I'm sorry, sir, could you please repeat the order again? I'm like, I want a Big Mac, large fries, is there a problem here, you know? And it's funny because then the manager turned around, looked at her, and she goes, what's the problem? I don't see a problem. All right. How's everybody doing?
Good.
We're doing all right? So then, you know, I also used to work at a video store. You know, I used to love movies and stuff like that. So then, as I worked in the video store, and you start watching all these movies and stuff like that, and I was thinking to myself, you start combining shit together, right, after a while, and you're thinking to yourself, what if Cheech and Chong met Scarface? It'd be something like this. Amen.
I think this is the house, man. I think we're okay.
Is this the place, man?
Yeah, man, this is the place. Relax, Holmes. It's all right. I think this is it.
Yeah,
man. It's all right. Calm down, man. But trip out. The guy said that, you know, whatever you do, don't fucking stare at the scar on his face, okay?
Yeah, I'm not gonna stare at the guy's face, man. All
right, just be cool, okay? I'm gonna knock on the door. Hold on. Oh, hey, man. Who are you?
Antonio Montana. And Joe, what you call yourself?
We're the guys, man. We here to pick up the shit, you know? So, what's the deal? You got the stuff?
Oh, yeah, I got the stuff, man. I got the stuff. I don't have it with me right now.
Oh, you don't?
No, I don't have the stuff with me right now.
Oh, okay. Where you got it?
I got close by, you know?
Is it in the car?
You know? Hey! Hey! What the fuck you staring at, man? nothing, man. I swear to God, I wasn't staring at the scar, man.
Shut up. So you don't have the stuff?
John, I was a political prisoner in Cuba. 8 fucking years. I had the octopus, had the fucking octopus coming out of my ears, okay? You tell him I got this stuff. Don't have me right now, okay?
No, it's cool, man. You know, I think we're gonna take off, okay? Let's get the fuck out of here. I think I have a cousin named Strawberry we're gonna go visit instead, all right? They go take off. All right. So then I was thinking, what if, talking about Scarface and shit like that, I was thinking to myself, what if Pee Wee Herman tried cocaine for the first time? A table, kind of table laid out, an old mountain of coke on there. And Pee Wee's just minding his own business, right? Kind of boxing his out.
I think I'm Scarface. I know, I got octopus coming out of my ears. Say hello to my little friend.
Oh, it's a pleasure to meet you.
If that wasn't bad enough, then you start thinking about La Raza, right? Because Raza, do we have any Raza in here?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. That's it, we fucked it all up now. Okay. Raza gotta fuck the shit up all the time, no matter where they go. And then you gotta start off first and foremost when they're out with their family, right? And tell me if this isn't true. You always see the mother out there with the baby and with her little stroller, and they're like at McDonald's. And tell me if they don't take the fucking beer, the bottle, right? The baby bottle. And what do? They load it up with soda. Right? And then they're pouring the soda in there. They put the nipple on there. And then the kids are like, the teeth are all rotten out. It's all silver teeth and shit like that. They smile. They look like Cujo, you know? I'm like, get that shit away from me. What's wrong with that kid? Fucking Rosemary's Baby over here. How are you? Shit. And then they go over to the swamp meet, right? And as you're in Calexico, they're like Santo Tomas, right? And, but then they don't call it the swamp meet. They call it what? The swamp meet. The swamp meet. They don't even know where they're going. Where are you going? That swamp meet? What's your favorite team? Los Doyers? Okay. And then they're there and they're shopping around, right? They're looking at the stuff. And then there's always some guy who takes like American trademark shit, and they do like some fucked up Mexican version of it, right? You can have like the Snuggie for one thing, right? And then the Mexicans like, oh, we can make it better and cheaper than that, right? And what do? They take like a fleece blanket that looks like it's been airbrushed by their tío, right? And then what do? They cut two holes in it and they go, aquí está el Snuggie. Es un Snuggie. That's not a Snuggie, it's a fucking blanket with two holes in it. No, it's a Snuggie, anda, toma $10. Fucking keep that shit, man. And then there's always these people. There's always the ladies that wear the stretch pants. Stretch pants should come with a weight limit. Anything over 350 pounds, do not wear the stretch pants. The shit is so stretched out, you could see the color of the chonies underneath it. Hey, they're white, I told you, I'm gonna paint me. This shit is like holding on for dear life, right? The threads are so spread out, they're like this. Shit! I don't think we're gonna make it! Like, hold on, brother, hold on! No, I think she's gonna have another hot dog. No, don't do it! Do it without the bacon, bitch! I can't hold on, tell my wife and kids I love them! RIP. Hey, my name is Jerry. Have a great night tonight. Thanks for being out here. Good night. Thank you.